What's up guys, SardinMeanTest here. I'm doing my tutorial on a Noctua NF-F12 industrial PPC 3000 PWM fan. Basically, I'm doing my setup as stock for what I'm currently running, what I was running. So you can see the fans, etc. set up in it. No cooler. All my fans, PSU. This is basically what I was running. I was basically averaging about max 65 Celsius on a full decent overclock whilst pushing, editing, etc. So I'm basically adjusting my fan speed now so it's all equal fan speed, etc. What I'm doing, I've got my fan set up so they're both on push. Like you'll see one fan and one radio pushing, another fan and another radio pushing. But on my other setup, you'll see in a minute that I've got it on a pull-push setup. So as you see guys, I'm just basically showing statistics of the actual CPU what I run on the benchmark, and now it's cooling down, you can actually see the full statistics on real temp. So basically everyone uses real temp to basically show what fan speeds or bloody, you know, how hot your CPU gets on different stress tests, because it's a more accurate, more reliable setup, etc, you know, whatever you want to call it. But yeah. So as all that's out of the way now, we can actually get on to the real bit of actually doing this fans after this. So here we go with the industrial PPC Noctua fans. Well, fan, not fans. Mostly the box is pretty decent, you know. All instructions on the back, how much it performs, etc. They're actually pretty loud, well not very loud, but they're loudish. I see that there's a premium colour now, no longer it's like that beigey sand colour. It's, you can take the actual rubber feet off if you want as well on this one. Comes in a normal box, good packaging, etc. Comes with four screws, so you can actually screw the fan into like a head or whatever. These are quite fitting, get the box mounted with one hand. Braided cables so don't get snagged, etc. And they look nice and decent as the case. Again, black. Like I said, it's pretty hard to do it with one hand. Four pin connector. got a nice decent length of the cable as well. As you see with Noctua, we'll always come with a premium design usually and a premium build quality. You do basically get what your money's worth out of these fans. They are probably the longest life living fans because the dual bearing system, if I'm right. And now it's basically setting up, taking the old fans off. These are not stock or not premium fans from Corsair. So now we're doing a side-by-side comparison of these two fans in a minute. If you get the case, the fan at the case. So yeah, as you see, the fans are obviously exactly the same size. They are 120mm. So basically we're going to put this new Noctua fan inside the actual heatsink, or between the heatsink. Make sure you go nice and comfy in there. Nice and set up now. Lights on. So yeah, I like to keep my case nice and tidy, through the wire, etc. Hope we get a 780 Ti hopefully very soon, or before the end of this year. Or wait until the new 800 cards come out, because that shouldn't be obviously very long. Basically I'm going to ramp my speeds up on by one fan, because it wouldn't be exactly fair running two fans against one fan. So if I give the other one a little bit of advantage, well, very minute advantage. You know, the fan is a lot faster than the other fans, but Noctua actually runs on static pressure. And very thank you to oclogs.co.uk for sending free tweets for the package of the Noctua fan. So yeah, back to benchmarking now. I'm basically pushing the CPU a bit more now to get the fan synced in, etc. Just to see how noisy it really is. Really, I'm not really a noise freak, so I can take quite a bit of that noise. I listen to music anyway while playing the games. Or probably if you guys wear noise canceling headsets, you're not going to really hear a PC that runs at 45 decibels or 50 decibels. Or even 60 decibels, whereas no person actually speaks at 60 to 75 decibels, so you're not really running very high. These temps are pretty close together actually, so I'm basically going to push these fan speeds all the way up now, so all my fans are all together pushing as much as they can, which obviously is going to give the benefit of the doubt, just to see how much, you know, noise it puts off. Not the quietest fans in the market, but not one of the loudest fans in the market at all. So you go guys, you're gonna use Cinebench now, because it actually tests different parts of core, or tests the core individually, etc. By pushing it for like editing or encoding, etc. But basically you wanna use different testing benchmark programs to just basically test how good your CPU is, but don't ever go try hard by pushing it for like 10 billion years, because it doesn't really do any good to your CPU, because it just adds miles to your CPU. Using Cinebench or whatever benchmark that gives score, you got to give it like every set like a pinch of salt or a pinch of sand or whatever you want to call it, because not all tests are always 100% accurate. Some can be the same even though you run the same statistics, the same setup. They will differ from now and again. Like if you move your mouse, the CPU is going to pick that up and trace it, and it's going to lower your score. If you open a program or a probe pops up, that's going to lower your score as well. So yeah. My CPU usually competes with a 4770K. So I'm pretty sure a third generation competing with a fourth generation CPU, or second, third, whatever you want to call it, generation CPUs competing, then it's pretty decent, I would say. You know that my CPU got a 10 meg cache, and the 4770K has actually got a 8 meg cache. Doesn't really give it a massive boost or difference. But yeah, not really a loud fan, as in my perspective, because I'm used to noise. But most of those guys will obviously what is a loud fan. You'd only use these fans preferably on water coolers, because the amount of static pressure the fan actually puts off, and if you go against a large fin cooler, I'm pretty sure it'd do very well. So guys and girls, if you'd like the benchmark, well basically test, not a new Noctua NF-F12 PWM 3000 RPM fan, then like and subscribe. If you'd like the video, thumbs up, like the video, thumbs down. And guys, thank you very much for viewing my video. Have a good day.